Hey guys, this is Jamil and you are watching JT CAD. This is a beginner's tutorial for making AutoCAD blocks. In this drawing, I want to show trees on different locations of my drawing, like here, 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 here. And I want to make copies of this same block. But right now it's not block, it is just set of drawing objects. Like this is line, this is arc, this is arc, like this. It's exploded block, you can say. So I would recommend whenever we are using multiple copies of same object in our drawing, I would recommend to make it block and then make copy of that blocks. You can use these blocks in different locations, and whenever you want to change that one block or all of the blocks, if you want to change at once, you can just change it by just one or two clicks, and that will be a very time saving task for you. So in this drawing I have made this symbol of tree, and I want to show this tree in multiple locations. So I want to make it block. So for that, making it block, I will just say B, enter, and this block definition window will open. I will name it TREE tree, and base point I will pick on the drawing in the center of the block. I will switch the snap on. I will click on the center point. This is X and Y will be center of this block. And objects, it is saying I will select objects. I will make it a window to select all of these objects. I will enter. And it is saying behavior, annotative, these things, they doesn't actually, it is not a big deal. Settings in units, you can make whatever units you are using in the current drawing. In description, you can say simple tree or the name of tree, whatever you want. For in one drawing, you can make different type of block. For each tree, you can make a separate block, and you can refer it here, or you can make it a name it different way. So I will say okay, and now this whatever objects I had selected now are blocks. I want to insert these blocks in here, 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 everywhere. I will say I, enter, insert windows open, and from the drop-down list I will just select it tree. If you have multiple blocks, all of them will be listed here. The insertion point I will specify manually from my mouse on screen. And scale I will keep it 1, 1, 1, and rotation I will keep it 0. I will say okay, and when I click, the block is inserted, this one and this one. Again I will say I, enter, okay, here, okay, and here, and again I will select tree. Okay, now these are the blocks that I have inserted. All of them are blocks. If I see the properties, you can see here, these are all blocks. Multiple blocks are inserted in the drawings. You got it? Now I want to change, maybe in after some time someone wants this block or this tree to be shown in a different way. I will go to block editor, just select it and right click, and from the menu you can select it block editor. Block editor will open. Maybe someone wants a circle around every tree. Okay, I will match the properties so that it will look a bit nicer. We'll close it and save the changes to tree. So here I see every, I will just right click, I will just click it, select it, and I will from clipboard, I will copy with base point, from center I will copy, and I will switch to the other drawing. From here I will go to clipboard, right click, clipboard and paste. That same block will be visible here also. And from here, if you will go to the properties, control 1, you can change the X and Y value, the scale of the block. Let me make it bigger. Scale, it is 9. I will make it 100 X and 100 Y and Z also 100. So it will be a bit bigger. Actually, it should be much bigger. So I will make it 500, 500, 500. So maybe this block, same block you can use for the other drawings also. Here. You can see here it is a block reference, and from the all this miscellaneous, you can see the name as we named in the other drawing. It is 3, so in this drawing it is a 3 also. So this is how you can use blocks and make new blocks in the drawing, and dynamically you can change whenever you want to change the block. So thanks for watching this video. Please let me know what you think about this video. If you have some better idea, do let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe JT CAD for more videos. In the next video, maybe I'll be showing you the dynamic blocks, how you can make calculations in AutoCAD drawings.